Coach, congratulations to move on to the next stage. So firstly, can you share with us your thoughts on the match and your team's performance, please?
Okay. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of God, the Passion and the Merciful. First of all, I have to say thanks about all of your journalists that supporting all the players, all the teams that coming to the press conferences and support them. And secondly, I have to thank from AFC that put this competition and very beautiful competition and very hard competition. So this kind of the players under 17, they are not playing for today. They are playing for the future. So we have to support all of them. My team performance, we know that how they played, but sometimes they playing very, very dangerously to counter-attack, and they are control the games inside their middle of the third. So we try to intercept and attack again, but they are very dangerous. Sometimes maybe they can score. This is very stressful, and I thank God that we can win. I have to say congratulations to all of my people, all of my countrymen, and I say thanks for the all the people that like us here, and thanks Thailand as well. Also,
thank you very much. So I will open the floor for the questions. If you have any questions, raise your hand, please.
Hello, Coach. Vinesh from AFC.com. Could you just summarize the first half and the second half for us in terms of your team's performance? Were you surprised that Yemen were playing a bit differently as the game progressed?
Yes, because we are analyzed all the team, and they are analyzed also too. So they analyze us. They know that we are very good in front in the channel of the right and left, and we can very good there. They close that areas and put some players inside the middle, and they only keep the ball, and they are only waiting for the counter-attack and one clever pass. So maybe sometimes you think that they are not playing with the attack players, and they play with the five defenses and three in middle and two insides, and all the players in middle, they control the game, passing to each other without fearing, and after that they waiting for the one counter-attack. After we went to inside the room and we talked with the players, I explained them how we have to play, because they are very dangerous. I'm thinking about that we have to stop first of all the counter-attack, interception of them, and after that we can destroy them. But we score one goal and we have two, three chances, and they have also good chances to score. But fortunately, or maybe unfortunately, it's going to the penalty, because I'm very glad that we are win and go to the World Cup. But I was very sad about the players of the Yemen, because they are crying, and I'm very sensitive. So I keep them in my arm and say, no, this is the nature of the football, and this is the something that we are dealing with. This business is winning business. So after this, we have to give them some experience that after this, they will develop, they will continue, and they have to give, we have to. We as a coach, we as a teacher, should be give them some inspiration and confidence for the future, because we are not playing here for today. We are playing in this age and level for the future. So in second half, we try hard. We score one. It was offside. I don't know. And they have some chances, and they have some chances also. But I think we play better.
Thank you very much. Any other questions from here?
Coach, something that was also mentioned by Yemen coach, which is the physical differences between the two teams' players. Do you think that this factor also helped your team to get some upper hand during the match today?
Look, for the fast players, the physically it's not so much important. The fast players should be inside the game. When Yemen team has the fast players in front, and he put three in middle. I think he has three or four center back, and they played all today. So he wanted to stop our physical players because we are good in air, and he knows that, and he stopped us. You know, honestly, I have to tell you, he stopped us and he played good. The players was good, but they play with their hearts, and this is the football that the Yemen played, and all of them was very fast. So from our side in defense, only the fast players, maybe it should be better. As you see, we play with the two center back that we started. They are not too much tall, but they are fast and clever, and they knows that how they have to play. And I told them, I advised them, because the rain is coming, and they are, I know that they are very fast and they are coming to interceptable. Don't make a risk and bring the ball inside the half of the opponent team.
Thank you very much. So I have an online participant here, so I got the question from him, so I will read. Okay. So it's from Elfan Hosseini from Golbezan. Congratulations on qualifying to the next stage and the World Cup as well. So penalty shootout went very well for your guys. So that players, including Alshar, goalkeeper, looked ready and confident. So did you practice for this situation in recent training session?
Every time, every sessions, we have the training about the penalties, because we know that with kind of the players that we have, maybe so much penalties occur. And for this moment that in 90 minutes is going through the penalty, we are starting from last month or 2 months ago, every sessions that we have end of that, we training about the penalties, and they are very good in penalties, and the goalkeeper also. And also we have two other goalkeepers, they are very good in penalty as well, but we don't change them. So yes, we train a lot about this matter.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any other questions from here?
Coach, just your short opinion on qualifying for the World Cup and what it means for you and your players.
I cannot understand, sorry. I was drinking water.
What does it mean for you and your players for qualifying for the World Cup?
Oh, okay, it means everything. Football is everything. Football is everything for football players, for the coaches. As you see, for all these matches, we living with football. We live in this beautiful game. And all my life, maybe all of my life, maybe only 12 years or 10 years of my life, I was not in football. So these players is living with football. I living football. As you know, I didn't sleep at night, maybe, because the matches is coming after each other. So maybe 4 hours, 6 hours, 5 hours, all of us working hard about analysis, about design a game plan, and how we design for the next match. As you see, every matches is changed, and it is very hard. If we play with the one system or one style, it's okay. But we have to change it, we have to think, and we have to stop the others. So this means so many things for us. And right now, thanks God, we went to World Cup, and right now I can sleep a little bit.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Any other question? If there's not, we will conclude the press conference. So thank you very much for your attending, and congratulations once again. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, and I say thanks again about you guys. From first moment I saw you, you have a very good energy, and so many journalists come here, and I love to talk with you, and I love to share my opinion and experience with you. Thank you very much. Thanks, Thailand. Thank you.
Thank you very much again.